From Universal Studios Hollywood, welcome to Home and Family.
He is an expert of Southern cuisine and one of my all-round favorite chefs. He's an executive chef at LYFE Restaurant. Chef Art Smith is with
us
today.
Yes, thank you.
Smith, this month is Heart Healthy Month, so you brought us some really great recipe today that's heart healthy.
Yeah, honey, we're going to talk chicken. And you're going to have a life, too, and you're going to keep it sexy.
Wow.
You know, so, you know, you know, I have lived the life of, you know, as they refer, as the king of comfort. And, you know, and the reality is that you got to be comfortable with your health.
Right.
And so, you know, it was something that was very important to me. And quite honest with you, I thought I was going to lose my life at 50 years old, but... We have a one now. We're doing well now.
Yes, so.
Good.
You brought in comparison. You brought the
exactly,
and
we have
we,
yeah, and we and then we have ours. And what's interesting is that you know food is delicious and wonderful, and it's a great way we come together. But also, you know, we can't use it as a way to medicate things. You know, and for many of us, you know, there's something comforting about eating something. And but the thing is that you can just make just one simple adjustment. And, you know, and like what your daughter Alex is doing with gluten-free and stuff, and how you can just cut the calories in half, and you can have it, and it tastes delicious.
And who doesn't love fried chicken, right?
Right?
Yeah. Speaking of food. Everybody's hungry over there.
Waiting. We want food.
You want food. You're going to love this food. He's a famous chef for his tasty Southern fried chicken. But just before his 50th birthday, you were diagnosed with type 2 diabetes.
Yes.
Now, how did that change the way you cook in your life?
Well, first of all, when you're given that information, you're just completely just kind of, you know.
Puts everything in perspective.
Exactly, yeah. Because you really realize that. You could fry your last piece of chicken.
Okay. Yes.
And in all seriousness, I lost, you know, a father and a grandfather, and so I did something about it, and I did it naturally. I just worked out, and with a great guy as Ferguson, a lovely Greek Australian.
Yes, okay.
Pretty will make you do all kinds of things, marathons, climb mountains, everything. And I started on this role, and I'm so happy. I lost 120 pounds. Jesus, my husband.
Wow.
Together, we have lost 165 pounds.
You lost a whole person. And you also started a new restaurant called LYFE.
Yes.
Which is LYFE.
Love your food every day.
Okay.
Because, you know, a lot of people, when you mention the word health and diet, they're like, I don't want to eat that. We're like, forget it. And so the reality is that great food can be great, not only in terms of taste, but also can be great for you inside. So let's face it. Everybody likes fried chicken. You know, fried chicken is one of those things that's
favorite.
So, like American is apple pie. But the reality is you can't eat it all the time. Well, this is something you can make all the time. Okay. And eat it, too. We've got some skinless breast chicken. You know, the fact is when you take the skin off, that's a lot of calories.
Of course.
I'm preaching to the choir. You know, you're the queen of cooking and stuff, so you know all that.
Well, then preach over here.
Preach over here.
Okay, because I'm waiting for
my
right, okay.
Their chicken.
Well, that's very important. And the other thing, too, is like what gives chicken a lot of flavor, and particularly in Southern fried chicken, is the fact that buttermilk has a certain acid. In fact, when the word buttermilk is, there's no butter in it. It's cultured. It's basically like kefir. It's a yogurt-based skim milk, which gives that flavor. And also, it tenderizes the meat and gives great flavor. And then what we do is we just take the buttermilk, we pour it over. You know, when we were developing this, most importantly was the fact is that I thought it was important that people have healthy, affordable food. The reality is, you know, America, a lot of Americans, I think every mother, every child, every person wants to eat something that's good for them and trust it, okay? And that was the main focus. Okay.
What did you just pour in there?
I put some hot sauce. Honey, you need a little caliente. You
know,
a little spicy. Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Because remember, when you're eating food.
What did you say? I missed that.
Honey, what did you expect, okay? Okay, so anyway. Anyway, the thing about it is you put the chili, which makes it, gives it a lot of great flavor because you don't have to use so much salt. So focus on using spices and herbs instead of sodium.
Salt, okay.
The biggest problem when taking food and making it better for you is reducing the sodium, so much sodium. So you let it marinate. Next thing you do, we're going to take some garlic powder. put it in.
What are you putting it into? What is this in here?
This is whole grain panko.
Oh, whole grain panko.
I think y'all say panko, but a panko, I don't know if you say whatever it is.
Okay, that's a Japanese breadcrumb.
Right, and then we're going to add some garlic powder. Okay, you can make this, Mark.
Now,
you'll be just cooking up a storm before it's over with. Yes, ma'am.
Why do you use panko instead of regular breadcrumbs for this recipe?
But one, because it's a larger grain, it's a more whole food, and the fact is it gives a much better texture and stays crisp. We're going to add a little bit of chili, not too much, or you'll be like, they'll be on fire.
Thank you.
A little paprika. And then we're just going to take those and stir those around, okay?
Oh, that looks good. You know what? I can even have this. I'm on our shred diet, but I can even have this chicken and the vegetables you're making today because you're also making some Brussels sprouts.
Exactly. Yeah. And what we do is we just take it like this. Why don't you just flip my chicken there for me?
I'm going to flip your chicken, okay? I'm flipping it. All right.
Whatever it takes.
Yes.
Okay. So what we've done is we've taken the chicken what you do is this is a great secret. Even if you're also doing fried chicken, you want to take the chicken, pre-bread it, and refrigerate it.
Why?
Because the coating will stay on. If you let it just sit on at least an hour, you won't have this problem with it falling off while you're cooking.
I've had that problem.
Okay.
How many of you have that problem when you fry? Even when you fry chicken.
Delicious.
Yeah.
Add a little.
The spice.
Yeah.
Add a little spray.
A little bit. Spray.
You add your chicken on there. Mm-hmm. A little bit more. And if you don't care if you're using the can, what you can do, thank you, dear, is you take that.
And you sprayed it on top also.
A little bit. Pop in the oven. Okay. Bake it about 30 to 40 minutes. Poof. There you have it.
Look at
perfect,
that.
Easy. And then, isn't that great?
That looks so beautiful. Look, I can't wait to taste it.
Well, but okay.
I'm going to taste it because I get to have it.
You know, Mom said eat your vegetables too, you know, and I think it's important.
Yes,
one of the things that I'm really big on is that a diet that's full of, you know, okay, again, you know, it's full of lots of vegetables and fruits, you're going to maintain your weight better than ever.
Yes.
And limiting,
it's good for you.
You know, the carbohydrates. Not saying you not have them, but you need to have good carbohydrates. And
so what did you do with these Brussels sprouts?
Very simple.
By the way, I can have this on my shred diet because I've compensated for my snack. So I'm going to eat my little chicken right here. Okay.
Being accountable.
And just keep in mind too, and you know, as you cook and everything, and particularly for your loved ones, thank you very much.
Oh my gosh.
It's
how great
thank
is this chicken?
Brussels sprouts are fantastic.
You can really taste the hot sauce in there.
Thank you. I'm a big believer that, you know, that everyone should eat the same food, and it's not about one person eating one particular. Everyone should eat it. Okay, so anyway, you've got Brussels sprouts. We add a little bit of extra virgin olive oil, and then we toss those just a little bit. You know, maybe a little bit of sea salt, a little pepper, and then we also have some butternut squash, and then we just add. You know, the whole thing is making your family fall in love with food again, but also fall in love with food that's good for them, and which is so important. And every day, mothers have such a challenge about getting their kids to eat properly. You know, I've been in the whole kid business for a long time, and I really believe in it. But most importantly, they're not going to eat what you're not going to eat. And remember, if you don't put it in your mouth, they ain't going to put it in their mouth. So remember, kids really love that. So you getting back to their vegetables, because I can sit and preach forever. Roast these for about 400 degrees. Okay.
For how long?
I roast them for about 30 minutes. Okay. And then the next thing after I do that, I'd like to toss them with just a little bit of vinaigrette. It's amazing that vinegar, like in any kind of vinegar-based sauce, is opposed to using cream or butter for people who have dairy issues and things like that. It really makes a wonderful flavor. It pops. Acid, to me, replaces the salt. And so then what I like to do is add some dried cranberries.
Love
them. And then you can add some chives. And there you have. You know, can you believe we serve 3 million people in Palo Alto? And I forgot how many thousands of pounds of Brussels sprouts because...
3 million people?
3 million people. I mean, Silicon Valley. Can you believe? So our second one now in Culver City.
Wow.
Oh my God.
I could eat that whole bowl.
Like a Brussels
salad.
I have a question. Where do you get panko? Where can you find that?
You know, you can get it in most, you can get it in most markets. And what I do, I have no issue with just saying to the grocer, can you get this for me? I want it. Mm-hmm. And that's the best thing. And but you get it in most markets because originally it was only found in Asian markets. Mm-hmm. But you can get it now in most markets. But you do have to request multi-grain. And just remember, they do make it and it is there. Like, you know, I live in Chicago and I need white lily flour because I'm Southern. You know what I mean when I make a biscuit? You know what I mean?
That's right.
I can make a biscuit sometime, honey.
Come back and
wanted some biscuit.
Let's do it. I want to do that shrimp creole we did before.
We met over biscuit.
I know we did. We did. But you know what? If you ever in Chicago go to table 52.
You remember my biscuits?
Yes, I remember your biscuits. Really.
I know you're on the diet now. She ain't thinking about my biscuits anymore at the moment.
No, and I remember your maple sugar bacon, which was to die.
Thank you.
So if you, again, if you're ever in Chicago, go to table 52. And in Culver City, the LYFE restaurant is now open. And you could go to our website if you want the full recipe for this unbelievable chicken. You could go to hallmarkchannel.com/homeandfamily.